Theories of Verbal Communication inaugurate Word, located on the second floor. Sections on rhythm, expression, style, humor and irony, literary genres, philosophy, history, the psychology and sociology of language, language and myth, lead the way to chronologically arranged sections covering European literature from ancient Greece to 20th century Russia. The sequence then moves to post-classical Greek and Latin from early lexicographers and grammarians to Renaissance and early modern humanists, arranged chronologically by country. There you can follow the rise and progression of post-classical Latin from Italy northwards and observe its expansion as the lingua franca of the early modern era. Three general sections frame studies on these sources: history of classical scholarship, the transition from the Middle Ages to the Renaissance, and the later influence of classical literature. The rest of Word concerns the various ways in which classical literature and themes survived and were disseminated. It begins with a section on mythographers, followed by ancient tales which left traces in manuscripts, printed books, visual images, and even films. There one finds ancient novels and their medieval successors: Attila, the Holy Grail, Arthurian romances, Tannhauser, the Wandering Jew, as well as the long and sinuous tradition of animal and plant fables and children's stories. Next come sections which document the emergence of a symbolic language resulting from the encounter of texts and images: Renaissance reinterpretations of hieroglyphics, emblems, impressa, mnemonic devices, ciphers, heraldry, post-stamps, ex-libris and printer devices. The final part of Word explores the transmission of classical culture through the transmission of knowledge. It starts with a section on encyclopedias, which goes from Greek and Roman compilations through Arabic compendia to medieval, Renaissance and modern Western European developments. The next sequence represents the neighbour genre of world chronicles. The following sections explore the various means of preserving and of disseminating knowledge. First, the history of manuscripts, printed books and libraries, then the history of education from schools to universities, of cultural exchange and travel.